morning, you guys. We are starting the day here again at Neptune's Dive Center. It is our last day diving here, and we are going to two shipwrecks, the Akitsushima and the Okikawa, which are bigger shipwrecks and they're farther away. They're about an hour and a half boat ride away. What are you doing this morning though, June?
Doing good. Ready for the depth dive?
Yeah, me too. And how about you, Mike?
I'm excited.
Me too. So the first ship that we're doing today is actually a seaplane tender ship. And what that means is it had a giant crane on top of it. It's about 150 meters long. And what they did was the seaplanes would land in the water, the crane would pick it up and put it on the ship, and then it just tended to the seaplanes. So that's all it was for. There's a couple cranes on this thing, but because it is so long, we actually cannot see this whole thing in one trip because it's also very deep. So our air is cut pretty short. So we're probably gonna be down there for about 20 to 25 minutes, as a typical dive is usually about 30 to 40 minutes. So it's a little shorter than usual because we're gonna be so deep. Also, to explore the whole thing, they said it would take about 3 dives. So we're gonna be exploring the best part where they had an anti-aircraft gun and the crane and all that. And we're gonna try and get inside as well for a couple pictures. So this first one I'm super excited for. It's like the most popular one when you search up scuba diving in Coron. And I'm excited to see this one. I feel like I'm suiting up for like a special recon mission. Like I'm a Navy SEAL or something. So I gotta put on all my gear here. I don't do it gracefully, but I still feel like I'm part of the Navy SEALs. Weight belt, check. Air, check. BCD, check. Let's go. So if you watched my previous shipwreck video, the Akitsushima was actually sunk the same day as all the other shipwrecks on September 24th, 1944 during World War II by an American air attack early in the morning. Now we actually didn't get enough footage the first day, so we went back the next day and did the same wreck twice, which is why we were able to cover a lot of this whole shipwreck, doing it 3 times out of the 4 that you really need to complete the whole wreck. So by this point you've seen the crane, the guns, the passageways, the engine room, and my favorite part, which was at the very end where we saw the jail cell, where people would be put in prison on this very boat. I thought it was really interesting seeing these bars and this very, very tight space that I had to squeeze through. Just finished the first dive, and I have to say, it was insane. This is probably by far the best wreck that we have done, and we probably only saw around 10 or 15% of it. Supposedly, it actually takes 4 or 5 dives to see the whole thing. We were down there for about 20 minutes, and then we had to like come up for another couple minutes. We're now heading to the second dive. It looks like it's starting to rain. I hope it doesn't mess with the visibility, but we're heading to the second one, which is a little shallower, so we'll be able to stay down, thankfully, a lot longer. Like a couple minutes ago, you could see this whole island. You probably saw from the drone shots, but now the rain is coming.
The wind's picked up.
It's dark with sunlight.
The horizon's not gone. Have you ever gone scuba diving in a thunderstorm?
Yes, at night, actually. I mean, no, what happens?
And this part, I will show you the bomb, not explode yet. I'm trying to detonate and then how they
not explode yet.
Not explode yet. We detonate today and then we can see how the impact is. Ding, ding.
This is gonna be a real exciting
dive. Yeah, this is when I show it to you, please don't touch it.
No, and, seriously, don't touch it.
Cody!
Yeah, Mike!
How you doing?
I don't know, man.
Hear the thunder? Hear the thunder?
There's a storm coming in.
This has become pretty badass pretty quick. I mean, it was badass before.
Dude.
But I gotta say, wreck diving.
It just got a whole lot more badass.
30 meters underwater.
Whoa!
Look at this rain. Woo! We're about to do the second dive today. It's the Okinawa. It's 160 meters long. It was an oil tanker that was shot. It burned for 3 days and it sunk to the bottom where it still is right now.
Oh, probably my most favorite dive because we're getting in there as the lightning is going, it's downpouring, we jump in and you can look up and see the lightning through the water. And then there's a huge current and it was like pushing us. So we had to really like fight to get like down there. And it was like a struggle when you're coming back up to like hold on to the line. It was like a true adventure. So that was why it was probably my favorite. And we went down in those holes. We saw like this big deep abyss. It was like the chamber. And man, it was by far the best one. Wouldn't you agree, Mike?
What's up?
We're now back at Neptune's Dive Center. I'm saying goodbye to June. Take care. Thank you so much, man.
Thank you too. Yeah, I do enjoy the dive.
I loved it. It was amazing. Thank you so much. And I hope to see you again.
Yeah.
Take care, man.
You too.
We're ending the video here. I have doubled my amount of dives just in these past couple of days. I was at like 8 before and now I'm at 17. So it's pretty awesome. And they were all shipwreck dives. They're all super, super fun dives to do. Thank you so much for watching. If you have not checked out Mike, check him out. He has been the one with the camera basically the whole past couple of days, getting all the amazing videos
Cody's
and photos
private
you've seen.
Underwater videographer.
I've got my own videographer here. So make sure you subscribe to him if you have not already. Subscribe to me as well and check out the last videos we've done here in the Philippines. Also, if you're in Coron, Palawan, check out Neptune's Dive Center. I swear it is a very, very good dive center and the guys here are awesome. So yeah, that is it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching and until next time, explore the world.